Hey, in this video, I'm giving you 5 powerful ways to shift into the 5th dimension. By the end of this video, you will know exactly how to shift into 5D reality, and you're going to be in a whole nother dimension. Check it out. What's up, you guys? Welcome back to another video. This is Meditation with Chris. My name is Chris. I help people raise their vibration and frequency and move to the next level through guided meditations and my YouTube videos as well. If you're new here, again, my name's Chris. I'm the business owner of Meditation with Chris, which is an online business where I provide one-on-one guided meditation services online over video chat and in person as well. If that's something that resonates with you, reach out to my Instagram or my Facebook page. But other than that, today I've got 5 powerful ways that you can shift into a 5th dimensional state of reality, consciousness, and awareness. So if you don't know anything about the 5th dimension or 5D reality, then what you're going to want to do is click the video above me right now. That'll bring you to the first video in this video series, which will tell you everything that you need to know about the 5th dimension. But other than that, we're going to dive right into video number 2 of my 5D reality series playlist. Let's do it. Alright guys, so 5 powerful ways to shift into the 5th dimension. What is the first thing that I have for us for today? The first powerful way that you can shift into the 5th dimension, and the first thing that you need to start implementing into your reality today to do so, is that we need to let go of control and ego. Now ego, this is what actually blocks our crown chakra. If you don't know anything about the chakras, click the video above. That'll tell you everything about the chakras, everything that you need to know about the 7 chakras, because they really do relate to the 5th dimension and 5D reality and expanding your consciousness and awareness and raising your vibration. They all connect together and are all part of this awakening process and remembering who we are, okay? So the first thing that I have for us for today, the first way to shift into 5D consciousness and awareness, a whole nother dimension, baby, the first thing that you're gonna need to do is let go of your ego and the need to control, because the need to control is what blocks out everything that is truly meant to be. Because the truth is, we're not in control of absolutely everything. We're only in control of ourselves and how we respond to the universe. And when we try to control every little situation, all we're really doing is causing resistance within ourselves and with the universe, because you can actually work with the universe by letting go of control, moving into a state of allowing and trusting the process, because nothing that's truly meant to be yours in this universe will be forced. So yeah, we need to like take action, and there's certain things that we need to do. We need to move into our perfect little flow state to start attracting the things that are truly meant for us. But that's all you really need to do. You don't really need to try too hard either. The most important thing that you really need to do to shift into 5D consciousness, or the first thing that you need to do, rather, is just let go of the ego and the need to control and just be yourself. Just be your true core authentic self, so that way you can attract the right things at the right time that are truly meant for you at a rate that best serves your highest good, okay? So 5D reality, this is a state of consciousness and awareness, and to really move into a new dimension, a new reality in general, realize that it is a state of consciousness and awareness, and your energetic vibration, this is what you are, this is the vibration that you are resonating at. And what happens is you are constantly emitting a frequency, almost like a radio signal, into the universe that is telling and sending information out to the universe, encoding it, and letting it know what it needs to send back to you. Because you never attract what you want, you always attract whatever it is that you are, whatever you are in vibrational alignment with already. Okay, so that's the first thing that you need to start implementing into your reality today to shift into the 5th dimension, to 5D consciousness and 5D reality. The first thing that you need to do is let go of control, which is connected to the ego, and that's actually what blocks the crown chakra. Again, if you don't know anything about the chakras, click this one above. The first one was chakra basics. This one will literally tell you signs that your chakras are blocked and how to heal them. All right, so let go of the ego. Let go of the need to control everything and every situation. And just realize that we're not in control of everything and every situation, but we are in control of how we respond to the universe. And the way that you respond to the universe has the power to change every situation just like that, like a drop of a dime. It can change your whole life forever by the way that you respond to the universe, all right? So that's the first way to shift into 5D consciousness and awareness, 5D reality. The first thing that you need to do is let go of the ego and the need to control. The need to control people, things, and situations, and just move into that state of allowing. And just trust that when you are being your true core authentic self, you will naturally start to attract the right things that are truly meant for you at the right time. All right? So what's the second way to shift into 5D consciousness today, instantly, right now? The second way to shift into the fifth dimension is to place your focus on love and put love first. Now, this really ties into self-care, self-worth, and just realizing what you're capable of, what you actually came here to do, and realizing your worth and your value, okay? So placing your focus on love and the love that you have cultivated within yourself first is the second way to shift into the fifth dimension, or a fifth dimensional state of consciousness and awareness, because that's what the fifth dimension is about. The fifth dimension is all about a heart-based connections with yourself and with other people first. And that's the first thing you need to do, is focus on the love that you have cultivated within yourself first. Because the greatest relationship that you could ever have is with yourself first, and you can never pour from an empty cup. So you can never even give other people love unless you have cultivated a certain level of love within yourself first, and a certain degree of love for yourself and for your life and your passion and your purpose on earth and what you are doing every single day, okay? So we need to develop a certain level and a certain extent of love within ourselves first. That way we can be open to giving and receiving love to other people, okay? So that's what the fifth dimension is about. The fifth dimension, there is no separation, there is no judgment, there is no ego, there is only oneness, and there is only love, okay? So in the fifth dimension, you love your neighbor. There is no separation, there is no judgment. We all love one another because we are all one. We are all the same divine force of energy experiencing ourselves in an infinite amount of ways. That's why what you put out into the universe comes right back to you. There is no separation, okay? Separation is the greatest illusion known to mankind, and that's what the fifth dimension is all about. It's about realizing that we're all one. We're all one divine force of energy, which is unconditional love. And what you put out comes back to you because, again, there is no separation. So once you place your focus on love, you'll start to shift into the fifth dimension, because again, you never attract what you want, but you do always attract whatever it is that you are, whatever it is that you are in vibrational resonance with. So once you move into your true core authentic state and you start placing your focus on developing a better relationship with giving yourself love and loving yourself and your life, and again, once you do that for yourself, you'll start to naturally attract people to do this for. You'll start to attract situations that resonate with this. Once you move into the vibration of love and gratitude and compassion, you start to naturally attract more things to be grateful for and compassionate towards. All right? So that's the second way to shift into the fifth dimension. The second thing that you need to start implementing into your reality today is to place your focus, because whatever you focus on grows in this universe. Paying attention. Paying attention is literally the greatest form of energy exchange that there ever was. Whatever you're paying attention to, you are directing your energy into this. When you're placing your focus and directing your energy into developing a better relationship with cultivating love from within yourself and giving love to others, and that'll connect to your passion and your talents too. Talent comes from the Latin word talentum, which means the sum of money. So your talents are connected to your passion and what you came here to do on the planet. So the second way to shift into the fifth dimension is to start developing a better relationship with giving of yourself and your gift and your passion and what you came here to do on the planet. Develop a better relationship with cultivating love from within yourself, okay? So what's the third way to connect and shift into the fifth dimension? The third most powerful way to shift into the fifth dimension today, instantly, just by making a conscious choice, is to start embodying the frequency of who you actually are, okay? So the truth is, you don't need to create your reality. You don't need to create certain things to happen. The truth is that everything already exists right now. That's it. Everything has already been created. And it's just a matter of getting in tune with the frequency or the vibration that you wish to be and attract into your life, okay? So all these versions of you, they already exist right now. Right now in the present moment. And you are not who you were in the past. You are not who you even think you are in the future, but you are who you choose to be in the present moment, okay? So what you can do to shift into the fifth dimension is picture your high vibe, fifth dimensional self, right? What would you be doing every single day? Picture the thoughts, the feelings, the actions, the beliefs, and the emotions that you would be feeling every single day when you're in the fifth dimension. And then all you need to do is model that. You need to model your fifth dimensional self right now. Start being that in the present moment and start moving into that frequency, okay? And therefore you will start emitting that frequency, and then you will start to attract all the things that resonate with that lifestyle at the right time when it best serves your highest good, okay? So that's the third way to shift into the fifth dimension today. Right now, make that conscious choice to shift into the highest version of yourself. Think about the thoughts, the feelings, the actions, the emotions that your fifth dimensional, most highest self would have. And all you need to do to shift into that parallel reality is to start letting go of the things that aren't serving you any longer and making the conscious choice to be that highest version of yourself by implementing the thoughts, the feelings, the actions that fifth dimensional highest self of yours would be and have, okay? So it already exists right now. The past, the present, and the future are all happening simultaneously. Every reality that you can imagine already exists right now. And it's about getting in tune with that, tuning into it like a radio station. It's like a radio frequency that is out there. You just gotta get in tune with it and get in alignment with it, okay? So that's the third way to shift into the fifth dimension. All right, guys, what's the fourth way to shift into the fifth dimension? A fifth dimensional state of consciousness and reality. The fourth thing that you need to do today is to follow your heart and passion and be present to the moment, okay? Now, this is such an important thing because your fifth dimensional self will be doing what you love every single day. You'll be passionate about waking up in the morning because you're actually doing what you love every single day, because when you're in the fifth dimension, you gotta be fulfilling what you came here to do on the planet, and that is connected to your talents. Again, I said this a minute ago, talent comes from the Latin word talentum, which means a sum of money. Your talents are literally meant to bring you eternal prosperity. This is why they come so naturally. You've been doing this for all eternity, all right? You are an infinite, eternal, spiritual being dreaming that you're having a human experience, all right? So the fourth way to shift into the fifth dimension today, right now, make that conscious choice to follow your heart and your passion. And all these steps connect together, right? So this kind of connects to the third one. Start embodying the frequency of your fifth dimensional self, the fifth dimensional self that you see yourself being. So to get there, you need to follow your heart and your passion and be present to the moment. So being present to the moment is one of the most important things that I could ever mention. And that's actually what meditation is. Now, I teach meditations. If that's something that resonates with you, you know, I mentioned this in the beginning of the video, reach out to my Instagram or my Facebook page. We can set up a one-on-one guided meditation. I specialize in harmonizing the seven chakras from within through guided meditations. But meditation, that is the art of absorbing yourself into the present moment 100%. So the past doesn't exist, it already happened. The future doesn't exist, it's not even here yet. But it's all about how you feel in the present moment and how you feel while you're going. That's how life works, that's how meditation works. It's never about the finish line or the end destination, it's always about how you feel while you're running the race. So you need to develop a better relationship with enjoying the present moment, okay? So. And once you're following your heart and your passion and you're doing what you love every day anyways, then it'll be much easier to enjoy and be in the present moment. And therefore you will actually enjoy what you're doing. Therefore you will get better results in the finish line anyways because you're actually present to the moment. You're actually enjoying what you're doing while you're going, okay? So that's the fourth way to shift into the present, into the fifth dimension, is just be present to the moment, follow your heart and your passion, because your fifth dimensional self will be fulfilling its life's purpose and mission every single day effortlessly. You'll be in this perfect flow state where you are doing what you love, doing what you came here to do. You'll be in the law of exchange, which is where you provide value out to the universe and the universe provides value back to you. You'll be in that perfect flow state, okay? But realize that Rome wasn't built in a day. Ancient Egypt wasn't built in a day. Good things take time and nothing good ever comes easy. And the day that you plant the seed is never the same day that you shall bear the fruit. But the moment you plant that seed, the moment you plant that seed, the closer you will ever be, okay? All right, guys, what's the fifth way to shift into 5D consciousness? The fifth dimensional state of consciousness and awareness, 5D reality, a whole nother dimension, baby, because you always attract what you are, never what you want, all right? So the fifth thing I have for us for today, the fifth way to shift into 5D consciousness is to observe the 3D, but do not pay attention to this, okay? Now, as I said before, paying attention is an energy exchange, okay? So whatever you're paying attention to, for example, I'm paying attention to my YouTube videos right now. I'm literally directing my energy into creating my YouTube, okay? So this is an example. This is an energy exchange. I'm directing my energy into this right now. So that's what paying attention is right now. Paying attention is literally the new currency. And money is energy too. This is why they call it currency, okay? But realize that the fifth way to shift into the fifth dimension is to realize that there's a split happening right now between the 3D and the 5D, okay? Now, what's the 3D? 3D is all these old societal rules that are falling apart, you know, whether it's, you know, the government or, you know, these, like, fast food chains that are pumping people with fear, or all these things that just are in the 3D reality, okay, that are based off of fear, that are based off of separation, that are based off of ego, that are based off of judgment, okay? The media comes from the ancient Greek goddess Medea, whose main traits were cunning and deceptive. The TV program, you're being programmed. Remote control, being controlled remotely. Alright, so the fifth way to shift into the fifth dimension is to observe the 3D and acknowledge it and notice it, but don't take part in it. Don't pay attention to it, okay? This is why a lot of people are living in fear and they're not manifesting their dream reality and what they actually came here to do on the planet is because they're placing their focus on the fear that exists in society, okay? And it's all in society anyways, because there's no lack and there's no fear in nature. In its essence, nature is purely abundant, okay? Lack is only something that is in society. So observe the 3D, but don't pay attention to it. Only pay attention to these beautiful fifth dimensional vibes. Direct your energy into these things with a choice, okay? It's all about where you place your focus, all right? So those are the five powerful things that I have for us for today. The five powerful ways to shift into the fifth dimension, our fifth dimensional state of consciousness and awareness. Alright, so long as you implement these tips and tricks into your reality today, you will be living in the fifth dimension and you will start to create a whole new reality for yourself. But other than that, I really hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a thumbs up if you did, or comment or tag and share this video with a friend so they can find some value here as well. And make sure you hit that subscribe button and a little notification bell so that way you can get updated every time I upload a new video. I got tons more content coming your way. But again, other than that, I really hope you enjoyed this video. Peace and love.